Hi, assalamu alaikum and a very good morning. So now we're going to do some tutorial discussion for chapter 7, focusing on the subtopic of 7.2, which is chemical properties of halal alkene. We're going to do tutorial question 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 respectively. Without any further ado, let us start. So for tutorial question 3, we have to state and write the reaction mechanism for each of the following reaction. So we have our third butyl bromide here, and it's going to react with a nucleophile of NaOH, and this is going to produce a secondary alcohol, a tertiary alcohol here. So the first thing that we need to know in the reaction is that we know that the Br going to be substituted with an OH. So you know that it will undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. However, you need to determine whether it will undergo SN1 or SN2. Okay, and in order to do that, you're going to look at the class of the hydrocarbon. So this class, this haloalkene here, will have a tertiary haloalkene because the carbon that attached to the halogen going to attach with 3 alkyl group. So it's going to be a tertiary haloalkene. And according to the flowchart I've given in the lecture, if a tertiary haloalkene, it will undergo SN1 mechanism. Okay, and SN1 mechanism, as you can remember, it's going to have 2 steps, and this apply for tertiary haloalkene. So 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so the mechanism is SN1 reaction, and it's going to have 2 steps, which is step 1, formation of the carbocation, and step 2 is the nucleophilic attack. So for the formation of the carbocation, we're going to draw the structural one again, and then what we're going to do first is we're going to remove the Br, the CBr bond going to be broken, and 2 electron is being transferred into bromine, and this will cause us the carbocation to be formed, as it is a slow reaction, and this is going to produce a carbocation, and the Br going to carry a negative charge here. Okay, as you know, the bromine going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lone pairs electron, and when 2 electrons are further being added here, it's going to have 8 electron in total. Okay, so the formal charge of the bromine is calculated from the number of valence electron, where the valence electron of bromine in the periodic table is in group 17, right? So you're going to have 7 valence electron minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8 lone pairs electron. And as a result, it will carry a negative charge here. Okay, for our carbon, it's going to carry a partially positive charge due to the same reason. Formal charge, carbon will have 4 valence electron and minus 3 bonding pair. So it's going to carry a positive 1 value. Okay, so now for step number 2, the carbocation that we have produced is very stable, which is a tertiary carbocation. So this will allow the nucleophilic attack by the hydroxide ion here. So they're going to be Na+. At the same time, it's going to have a hydroxide ion because it exists as the aqueous, so it can be dissociated to ion. So the OH minus, where the oxygen carry a negative charge, going to attack the positive charge of the carbocation. And this is going to happen at the fast condition, and this is going to attach the oxygen with the carbon. And this is going to produce our alcohol here. Okay, and this is the same as the product shown in the reaction. Okay, and as you know, the oxygen here going to have six lone pair electron, and then it carries a partially negative charge. So when 2 electron is being transferred, their lone pair is diminished, dah dihilangkan, dan menjadi 4 lone pair electrons. So lastly, the OH is going to have, it's going to be exist as this form or in this form. So oxygen will have a formal charge of 6 valence electron minus 1, 2, 3, 4, and that is why the oxygen will carry a neutral charge. There's no charges positive or negative because the charge is neutral. Okay, now for the next reaction, which is B here. So the same method, we have to identify the class of the haloalkene. So if we were to expand the structure, we're going to get as CH and then Cl here. So the carbon here that is attached with the halogen going to be attached with one alkyl group. So here is the primary haloalkene. So for the primary haloalkene, it will undergo SN2 when it is a low steric hindrance. So here is a very low steric because it only consists of a small alkyl group. Okay, alkyl group yang kecil dan steric dia adalah rendah lah. Maksudnya dia tidak terhalang untuk diserang. Okay. And as a result, the OH minus ion which act as a nucleophile gonna attack the carbon and this gonna break the bond in between the CCl here. Okay, and we're gonna draw the transition state where at this point the OH gonna make a bond in between the carbon and at the same time the CCl bond gonna almost be broken down. And as a result, at the end of the reaction, which happens at first, the OH bond will be lit, the O and C bond will be fully formed, and the Cl bond here gonna be broken. Okay, and as a result, the Cl will carry a negative charge, and the OH here gonna enter and forming a bond. Okay, so the transition state here is something that you need to show. And the one thing that you need to consider is that the OH need to attack at the backside dari belakang dari belakang of the CCl halogen bond. Okay, and initially the configuration in 3D gonna be something like this, seperti penyapu. Tetapi by the end of the reaction, the configuration gonna be inverted to be this way. So this is the compulsory way of doing this. Okay, because the nucleophile is very, very strong and it attacks here and change the configuration to be inverted and the Cl gonna be removed here. And of course, you can fully fill the fluorine with 8 lone pairs electron. Alright. For tutorial question 3C, we were given a structure of third butyl and then attach with a CH2Br here. So if we were to expand the structure, we're gonna get a primary haloalkene. Okay, because this carbon here is attached with one alkyl group. Okay, so sepatutnya dia adalah primary haloalkene. So you will expect it to undergo SN2. Tetapi, because it is consists of a very large group here, it is being, dia adalah terhalang untuk diserang oleh nucleophile. Okay, because it has a high steric hindrance. Okay, so when it has a high steric hindrance, for example, CH3, CH2Br here, it will undergo SN1. Okay? So it will undergo SN1 instead of SN2. Okay, and as you know, SN1 will consist of two steps. So we're going to draw the structure again, which is the CCH3CH3 and then CH3 here. When we expand it, we're going to have CH-CHBr here. So on the first step, the CBr bond is going to broken and two electrons going to be transferred into bromine. And this will causes a formation of the carbocation, which is a primary carbocation because this carbon is attached to one alkyl group. And we're going to produce a Br minus. Okay, and of course, you can fill it with all the lone pair electron if you want. Okay, and initially, this primary carbocation is unstable. So what they're going to do is they're going to do and rearrangement processes where the CH3 going to be transferred to this side so that we can form a tertiary carbocation which is much more stable. So what we're going to do is 1-2 methyl shift where we're going to transfer the methyl group into this side and this is going to causes the positive charge to be transferred here. Okay, so by the 1-2 methyl shift process, we're going to produce a tertiary carbocation, which is a much more stable carbocation. And the hydroxide, which is coming from the NaOH here, which acting as the nucleophile, going to attack the electrophile, which is the C plus here. And this happens at the fast condition. Here is low. And this going to causes the attachment of OH group into the carbon here. And this shows that there is a formation of our major product. Okay, CH3, COH, CH3, CH3, CCH3, OH, and then CH2, CH3, CH2, CH3. So, which is an example of the major product. Okay, so we're going to state it as SN1. And at the same time, some of the OH can basically attack the carbocation without being rearranged. So maybe there might be a tendency for the nucleophile to attack here without the rearrangement. So in this process, it's going to produce a minor product here. Okay, because OH is attached on the last carbon. So OH is attached at the last carbon. All right. Okay, for tutorial question 4, we have to arrange the following compound in order of decreasing reactivity towards SN2 reaction with aqueous solution of NaOH. So given here is that we have the CH3-2 attached with CH-CH2-Br, and we have an aliphatic straight chain of CH3-CH2-CH2-CH2-Br, and then we have a tetbutyl attached with a CH2-Br here. So for SN2 reaction, we know that it is better if we are having a primary haloalkane. Okay, and this is as mentioned by a flowchart as mentioned in the lecture. So primary haloalkane will be better to undergo SN2 when it has a low steric hindrance. So the first thing that we need to look at is whether it is all primary haloalkane or not. So if you were to expand this structure, we know that it is a primary haloalkane. So here is a primary haloalkane, and here is also a primary haloalkane, and then here is also a primary haloalkane. Okay, so everyone is a primary haloalkane, but what makes them differ towards the reactivity of SN2 is due to the steric hindrance. Okay, so the lower the steric hindrance, the better it is to undergo SN2. So that's our idea here. Okay, we can say that the primary haloalkane with the lowest steric hindrance is the most reactive towards SN2. And the best way to look at it is we try to draw the structure and whether to see whether it is steric or not. Okay, so let us draw the structure one by one. Let's say if I start with the CH3, CH2, CH2Br. So I know that I'm going to have 4 carbon chain, and then it is attached with a bromine. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and attached with a bromine. And then if I were to draw this one next, I will have a 1, 2, this carbon here, attached with two metal group, which is here and here. And CH2 going to be attached with a bromine atom. Okay, and for the last structure here, I can draw it as this form where the C here going to be attached with 3 metal group, and this going to connected with CH2Br. Okay, from the structure shown here, you can see that this structure will have no steric hindrance. Dia tidak terhalang untuk diserang oleh nucleophile. Okay, for here, it will be very little steric hindrance. Okay, but here is having a high steric hindrance. Okay, this is because the nucleophile cannot attack this carbon because it was blocked. Dia dihalang oleh that butyl group here. Okay, this one it is being blocked, however, not as bad as this one. Okay, So you know that the one that will have a lower steric hindrance will be more reactive towards SN2. So here is the most reactive because it has no steric hindrance. This one is second and this one is third. Okay, so you can say that the CH3, CH2, CH2Br is more reactive than the second structure here and more reactive than the third butyl CH2Br here. Okay, for tutorial question 5, we have to draw all the four structural isomers for the C4H9Br. So, the structural isomers is something that you have looked in the chapter 4 of semester 2. So, structural isomers will have three types, which is the chain isomer, the positional isomer, and functional group isomer. So, for this case, we're going to do four structural, which is consists of the chain and positional isomer. So the best way to start is, I think, is to draw the aliphatic haloalkane. So we have four carbon chain. So we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 carbon, and then you're going to attach with Br. So maybe we can start from here first. So we can draw our carbon chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, and attach with the Br group. So this is going to be our first isomer. Our second isomer, we can bring our Br here and attach it to this carbon. So first you're going to have bromobutene and one bromobutene, but when we transfer our Br to here, okay, so you can draw it in terms of the skeleton structure, and you also draw it in terms of the condensed structure, doesn't matter. And as I mentioned, we can bring the Br to this carbon, and as a result we're going to get two bromobutene. So you can also draw it in terms of the skeletal and as well as the condensed structure. So now, we already got two isomers. What we can do now, we can try to shift our carbon chain. Okay, so maybe what I can see from here is I can bring my carbon chain to this side. Okay, so what I'm going to get is something like this. Okay, so we have bromopropane, and at carbon number 2, it's going to be attached with methyl. Okay, so you can also draw the condensed structure to be C, CH3, and CH3 here, and that is why it becomes CCH32, and then it's going to be attached with CH2 and Br at the end. Okay, and for the last structure, we can do the third butyl. So the third butyl will consist of 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon, and then it's going to attach with a bromine. Okay, so that's going to be our fourth structure. Okay, and you can always check back whether your structure is correct or not by counting the number of carbon and hydrogen that are present. So for D, you will have CH3 here, CH3 here, and CH3 here. So the carbon gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4, which is C4. Hydrogen gonna have 3, 6, and 9, H9, and bromine gonna have 1. Okay, so it is consistent to the molecular formula given. Okay, same goes to here. So you have C, H, you have CH3, you have H, C, and then you have CH3 at the end. Okay, so if you were to count, you get 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon. Hydrogen, you're gonna have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then Br. So the structure, the molecular formula is consistent. So you know that you are doing a correct structural formula. Okay, and for D, you can also represent it in terms of CH3. Three, where this C is attached with three group of methyl. Okay, and it's attached with the Br here. Alright, now for tutorial question 5b, which of the isomers will react most rapidly with aqueous NaOH through the SN1 reaction? So the SN1 reaction will have two steps, and then it will be better for the tertiary haloalkane to do so. Okay, so In this case, we need to identify the class of the haloalkane. So here going to be a primary haloalkane. Here going to be secondary because this carbon is attached with two carbon chain. And here going to be primary because this carbon here is attached with one big group here. And then here, this carbon here going to be a tertiary haloalkane because it's attached with 1, 2, 3 alkyl group. So the tertiary haloalkane belongs to the structure D. So you can say that the isomer D will undergo reaction most rapidly through the SN1 reaction. And this can also be validified by using at the flow chart here. So tertiary haloalkane will undergo SN1 beta. So it is a structure D. Now we have to choose two isomers which can react with KOH in ethanol to produce the same alkene. So when we have KOH and ethanol, it is the reaction of elimination where we're going to remove hydrogen as well as the halogen. For example, Br in this case. So it is a dehydrohalogenation process. Okay, so let us look into one by one. Okay, so let's say if we look at the structure here once again. So let's say for structure A, if we're going to remove Br and hydrogen from this side, what we're going to produce is an alkene here, which is 1-butene. So Br and the hydrogen from the adjacent carbon. Okay, bromine dibuang dari sini dan hydrogen dibuang dari carbon that is next to it. Okay, so it's going to produce 1-butene. For this case, we can remove Br from here and we can remove hydrogen, let's say, from this side. Okay, so what we're going to get is also 1-butene. Okay, however, if you don't want to remove hydrogen from this side, you can remove it from the middle side here. Okay, so if you remove bromine and remove hydrogen, what you're gonna get is you're gonna get the double bond here. So what you're gonna get is 2-butene. Okay, and the 2-butene here going to be your major product because it is a more substituted alkene according to the Saint-Zeff rule. And this one going to be the minor product. Okay, so for B, there going to be two possible structure, which is one is minor and one is major. So, yeah, so you're going to have two, but more of the structure is on the major product here. For C, if it undergo dehydrohalogenation using KOH in ethanol, what you're going to do is you're going to remove Br and you're going to remove the hydrogen here. Okay, so here got C, H, and H. And you remove Br from this carbon and you're going to remove hydrogen from the next carbon. Okay, so what you're going to get is to be something like this. Okay. And for this case, also, you're going to remove Br, and then you're going to remove hydrogen from this side, or hydrogen from this side, or hydrogen from this side. It doesn't matter because it is symmetry. Mana-mana pun akan mendapatkan jawapan yang sama. So, let's say if I remove hydrogen from this side, okay, and here, what I'm going to do is the Br and hydrogen here are going to be removed, and this is going to produce a double bond here. So this can also be represented as this way. So this one and this one is the same. Okay. So for C, I can say that the one that produces the same alkene is product C and B. Okay. For A and B, it is not quite so because the For the B, when it undergo dehydrohalogenation, it's going to be produce the major product more. So we cannot say that it have the same alkene. The most obvious one is C and D. Okay. Now for question 6, based on the given reaction scheme, we have to suggest reaction X, reagent X, and the structure P and Q. Okay, so reagent X is started from an alkene. Okay, here is an alkene, and then we're gonna add H and gonna H and gonna add Br here. Okay, so Br is attached to this carbon, and hydrogen gonna attach at this carbon here. So you know that one of your reactant gonna be HBr. Okay, so if you write HBr only, what you're gonna get for your product gonna be CHBr and CH3 here. Okay, so it gonna follows the Markovnikov rule, where hydrogen gonna be attached at carbon with more hydrogen. Okay, so if you only write HBr, you will get this product. Okay, and that is why we also need to add peroxide. Okay, so that we can follow the anti-Markovnikov rule. Okay, so if you add HBr only, the answer is wrong. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna add HBr with the presence of peroxide. For example, you can use HOOH or H2O2, or you can even use CH3OOCH3. Okay, doesn't matter whichever the peroxide that you want. Okay, by following anti-Markovnikov, the bromine will be attached at the carbon with more hydrogen. So Br going to be attached at the last part, and the hydrogen going to attach here, so that it will give the product that we wanted. Okay, so for X, we can write HBr and ROOR. Okay, so in the exam, please specify the R. So make sure you write CH3OOCH3 or HOOH. Okay, don't leave it as R. Okay. And for Q, it is a nucleophilic substitution reaction because we have OH here. Okay, so the OH here gonna replace the Br, and this gonna produce a benzene ring attached with CH2CH2. Br gonna be removed, and then OH gonna be attached here. Okay, so this will undergo SN2 mechanism because it is a primary haloalkene. Okay, so the similar process is happened for KCN, where KCN, CN minus here refers to a nucleophile. So because it is a primary haloalkene, the CN gonna attach here and Br gonna be removed. So the expected product that we can get for P is we're gonna replace the Br with CN. Okay, for Q, we're gonna replace Br with OH. So it is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Alright. So for tutorial question 7, we have to show how a Grignard reagent is prepared from 1-bromopropane. So 1-bromopropane can be drawn as a propane group, which is 1, 2, 3 carbon, and then the bromine gonna be attached at carbon number 1. So you can attach it here or you can attach it here, because if Br attached here, this is going to be carbon number 1, carbon number 2, and carbon number 3. And then when we are talking about Grignard reagent, it means that it's going to be reacted with a magnesium metal, and the solvent going to be our dry ether. And this is going to produce a Grignard reagent of MgBr. Okay, so here is the structure, plus magnesium metal, dry ether, and then we're going to produce a Grignard reagent. So you can draw it in terms of the skeleton structure, or you can draw it in terms of the condensed structure here, whichever structure that you want. Okay, so for part B, we have to draw the structure formed when the above Grignard reagent reacts with the following. So the Grignard reagent that we have formed, we can draw it again here. which is the CH3, CH2, CH2 MGBr. And at the same time, I also put the skeleton structure here. So for B1, we're going to react our Grignard reagent with a methanol, which is CH2 followed by hydrolysis. So this reactant plus another reactant, which is the methanol, CHHO followed by hydrolysis. So hydrolysis here refers to H2O and happen at acidic condition. So what happened here was we're going to produce an alcohol. So MgBr going to be removed, and this going to be replaced with attached with the methanol here, where we're going to add one carbon group, which is C here, and then we're going to have OH and hydrogen here. So it's going to produce a primary alcohol. Okay, so it's going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then OH going to be here. So as what you can see, initially it has 3 carbon, but due to the addition of the methanol, we're going to become 4 carbon, and O here going to become OH due to the hydrolysis reaction. Okay, so you can draw it in terms of the skeleton structure, or you can also draw it in terms of the quantum structure here. Okay, and for the step, for the second reaction, is we're going to react the same Grignard reagent, and then we are adding with the methanol followed by hydrolysis. So sorry, this one is aldehyde. So aldehyde going to be drawn as CH3, C double bond, and H. Okay, so you're going to add your methanol here, and then due to the reaction of MgBr, the Grignard reagent, and aldehyde at acidic condition, so you're going to replace the MgBr, and then you're going to attach the aldehyde here, which you have 1, 2 carbon, and then the O going to become OH. So O going to become OH. Okay, so it's going to become a secondary alcohol. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and then going to be 5 carbon. So because initially they're going to have 1, 2, 3, and then they have 1, 2 carbon here. So 3 plus 2 going to have 5 carbon, and then the oxygen here going to become OH. Okay, and it's going to produce a secondary alcohol. This one is a primary alcohol. So you can also draw it in terms of the quantum structure here. Now we're going to do the next reaction, where we're going to react a ketone, where the ketone will have a formula of CH3, C double bond O, and then CH3. So we're going to draw it here, and this is going to happen under hydrolysis with water. So the MgBr going to be replaced with the ketone here. So it's going to have 1, 2, and then OH here. Okay? So it's going to add 3 carbon group. So from 1, 2, 3, it's going to become 3. We're going to add up with another 3, so it will become 6 carbon chain. So it's going to become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And the OH here is going to be attached at here. And the carbon that is attached to the OH is going to be attached with 1, 2, 3 alkyl group. So it's going to be a tertiary alcohol. So you can also draw it in terms of this structure here. Okay, and for the step number 4, the same structure, which is the Grignard reagent, when it is reacting with the carbon dioxide followed by hydrolysis, so carbon dioxide can be drawn here, followed by hydrolysis, you know that you're going to produce a carboxylic acid. So MgBr here, 1, 2, 3, and 4, because initially they're going to have 3 carbon, when you add up carbon dioxide, it's going to produce a carboxylic acid. So one oxygen going to be having a double bond, and another oxygen going to have OH here. So it's going to become 1, 2, 3, 4, which is a butanoic acid. Okay, so you can draw it in terms of this structure, or an expand and a condensed structure here. So here going to be a carboxylic acid. And the last part, if we're going to react our Grignard reagent with just hydrolysis process, which is with water, we know that the initially we're going to have CH3, CH2, CH2, MgBr, right? So MgBr going to be removed. So the CH2 here going to add up with another H. So it going to become CH3, CH2, and CH3. So it's going to become an alkene with three carbon chain. 1, 2, and 3. So you can also draw it in terms of the condensed structure as CH3, CH2, CH3 here. Okay. And for the hydrolysis part, there will be no addition of the carbon chain. Mula-mula 3, 1, 2, 3, and akhirnya dia ada 3 juga. However, when there is addition of carbon chain, for example, carbon dioxide, it's going to have extra carbon here. So it's going to become 1, 2, 3, 4, because initially they have 1, 2, 3, because adding 1 carbon, it's going to become 4. Okay, the same principle apply for the upper part here. Okay, and remember during exam, you always need to add the reactant as the plus sign. Jangan letak di atas arrow. Alright. Now we're going to complete the mind map given for the tutorial question 8. So we can look at this as our starting part, which is our primary haloalkane. Okay, so this is known as the bromoethane. And we're going to do this side first because it only got one. So here we have a strong nucleophile and ethanol. So when we have this condition here, you know that we will undergo the dehydrohalogenation. So dehydrohalogenation means that we're going to remove Br and we're going to remove one hydrogen. Okay, so if we were to draw the structure, 1, 2, so gonna be 1, 2 and then Br here. So hydrogen gonna be removed from this side and Br removed from this side, and what we're gonna left is a carbon double bond here. So we're gonna have CH2 double bond CH2. Okay, and remember the Br and H gonna be removed from the adjacent carbon, bukannya pada carbon yang sama. Okay, so you're going to remove it at their jiran. Alright, so what you're going to get is CH2 double bond CH2. Alright, now we're going to look into on the right hand side. Okay, so on the right hand side, you still have this structure here, which is the bromoethane. And when it is reacted with NaOH, you know that a nucleophilic substitution reaction will occur. Okay, so the Br gonna be replaced with OH here. So what you're gonna get is a primary alcohol, which is an ethanol. So you can draw the structure here. 1, 2, and then OH. Alright, and now the same structure here, which is CH3, CH2, Br, and we're going to produce NH2 here. So you know that from Br, we're going to change it with NH2. So the nucleophile that we can use is ammonia, which is NH3. Okay, and we need that in excess. And we also need the solution, the solvent, which is an ethanol for the reaction to occur. So NH3 going to attack the this carbon, which is the electrophile, and this going to remove Br via the SN2 mechanism. So NH2 going to be attached here. So the answer is we going to have the excess NH3 with the solvent of ethanol. Alright. So for the next box here, we're going to react the CH3, CH2, Br But now we're going to have the KCN. So CN here going to be acting as a nucleophile, where the CN going to be attacking here, and the BR going to be removed. Okay, so this happened via SN2 mechanism, where the N here need to be subscript and number 2 here. So you can draw it as CH3, CH2, and CN here. Okay, and also you can draw it in terms of the condensed structure here. Okay, now, for the next box here, you're going to replace BR with OH. So you know that you can use your water in order to attack here, and BR going to be removed out, because water, the same as ammonia, will have the lone pair. So lone pair on ammonia and lone pair on water, where water will have two lone pairs. So it is also acting as a nucleophile in order to remove the BR. Okay, and now we're gonna look into the next box here, which is the same structure of haloalkane, and it's gonna react with CH3OH. So here we're gonna have a nucleophile of CH3O- and H+. Okay, so the nucleophile gonna substitute the BR here. So what we're gonna get at the end is CH3, CH2, and then OCH3. Or you can draw it in terms of lines. So you can get CH3, CH2, OCH3. Okay, and for the last box here, for this box here, you're gonna do the same thing, where you're gonna predict the reactant here. So you can also use the same one, which is the CH3OH in this sheet here, or you can use OCH3, which is negative charge, and you can put a plus or a positive charge metal, for example sodium metoxide here. Okay, so you can put it as CH3ONA, and the CH3O- gonna replace the BR in order to produce the product here. Okay, and for the last part here, which is the CH3COONA, it's gonna produce the nucleophile of CH3COO- with Na+. So this nucleophile is going to replace the BR. So what you're going to get is CH3, CH2, and then it's going to attach with the oxygen, and then the attach with the carbon with the double bond and CH3 here. Okay, because the oxygen is going to carry the negative charge, so the oxygen is going to attack the carbon. So at the end, what you're going to get is CH3, CH2, and COOO, CH3. Alright? So this is known as the carboxylate ion. Okay, now we already settled with this part, and we already settled on this part here. So what we're going to do that next is on this section. So from the haloalkane that we have produced, which is the CH3CH2BR, when we're going to react that with magnesium and dry ether, you know that you're going to produce a Grignard reagent, where the Mg is going to be attached on this side here. So you're going to get CH3CH2MgBr. Okay, and when the CH3CH2MgBr, which is on this section here, reacting with hydrolysis of water, the MgBr here going to be replaced with hydrogen. So what you're going to get is CH3 and CH3, which is an ethane. Okay, So we can also draw a straight line because CH3 and CH3. Alright. And now the same one, which is your Grignard reagent. And for the Grignard reagent, you need to produce carboxylic acid. So when you know that you're going to produce a carboxylic acid, you're going to react it with carbon dioxide followed by the hydrolysis. Okay, so number one, carbon dioxide, and number two, hydrolysis process. So your MgBr here going to be replaced with C double bond O and OH. Okay, so these are the condition here. Okay, and for this side, you are using your Grignard reagent, the same Grignard reagent, and now you're going to react it with methanol under hydrolysis. So you know that when you are reacting with methanol, you're going to get a primary alcohol. So primary alcohol means that you're going to attach with another carbon chain, and then you're going to have H and H here, and then OH. So it's going to be a propanol because it's going to have 1, 2, 3 carbon and then attach with oxygen. So it's going to be a propanol, sorry. So it's going to be a propanol. And for this section, is the same thing, but now we're going to produce a secondary alcohol where one of the hydrogen going to be changed as methyl group. Okay, so this is known as a secondary alcohol because this carbon here attached with two alkyl group. And for the last one, it is the same thing as before, but now the hydrogen going to be changed with another CH3. So this carbon here going to be a tertiary alcohol because this carbon is attached with 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so also yeah, here is the product, and then we need to identify its reactant, which is the ketone here. Okay, and we also need to write the water and H+, which refers to the hydrolysis at acidic condition, and this is going to produce a tertiary alcohol. Alright, so I think that's all for this video. See you again some other time. Bye.